Hello friends, welcome to my channel Basic Life Science. So today I will deal about all you need to know about the D614G strain of coronavirus. So in the news articles, in the news all over, we can see they are talking about D614G coronavirus strain. So there are many questions that remain not that much clear. So I'll clear up your confusion. The questions that are coming out is, why was the mutation named D614G? And is the D614G strain more contagious? Is the mutation likely to affect the efficiency of COVID-19 vaccines? And many more questions. I will try to clear your confusion. So, on 17th August, Malaysian Health Ministry announced that D614G, a mutation of SARS-CoV-2 virus which causes COVID-19, has been detected in at least 3 of the 45 cases in a cluster that started from a restaurant owner returning from India and breached his 14 days home quarantine. So that's how the virus spread and Malaysian government came to know about it. Now, why was the mutation named D614G? The SARS-CoV-2 is the official name given to the novel coronavirus that causes COVID-19 disease. The D614G is the name of one of the mutation of the virus. As you already know, the coronavirus is made up of spike proteins. According to researchers, D614G is also present in those spikes itself. This mutation changes amino acid at the position 614 from D, that is aspartic acid, to G, that is glycine. Hence, it is named D614G. So, in the coronavirus, there was in 614 position, there was aspartic acid. But due to the mutation, in the place of aspartic acid, there is glycine. So, the mutation caused change in the position 614. In place of aspartic acid, there is glycine now. So, the next question is, is the D614G strain more contagious? There can be three effects of the different mutation that a virus undergoes. The mutation can make the virus more contagious. It may hinder the replication of virus, or it may have no effect at all. Unfortunately, the D614G mutation is likely to increase the contagious nature of the SARS-CoV-2. So it is more contagious according to the researches that are going on in the cell. The magazine have already said about it, many thing about it, and they have an research about these things. So now, is the mutation likely to affect the efficiency of the COVID-19 vaccine? Although the 614G mutation happens in the viral spike protein, it does not change the receptor binding domain, the RBD domain, at the tip of the spike protein. So the RBD domains are present at the tip of this spike protein. These are the spike proteins that are present in the coronavirus. The RBD binds to the ACE2 receptor on human cell. It is also the main target of the immune system. The ACE2 receptor that is present in the human cell membrane. In essence, the D614G mutation alters the spike protein but not the critical RBD immunogenic part. So it is not affecting the RBD part. So earlier it was speculated if we will need to develop separate vaccines for different variants. But however, most of the vaccines in development are based on a different region of the spike. So this should not have an impact on their development, so there is no need to panic. So now, if you want to subscribe to my channel, you can subscribe to my channel. I will update more and more interesting videos and the updates of the coronavirus. And there is one flowchart for your understanding of how the coronavirus infects the human cell. So the flowchart is here. Here we can see there is ACE2 receptor that is present in the cell. So the virus comes and the spike protein attach with this receptor. This receptor helps the coronavirus to enter the cell. The virus enters the cell body and releases its RNA. So virus releases the viral genomic material, that is RNA. Then the virus RNA uses the host cell to create new virus RNA and assemble new viral particles. It will produce new virus RNA, the genetic material, the code protein, etc. Everything it will produce inside the cell, it will hijack the cell's machinery. Then it will produce new variants, that is virus particles are produced and they are released from the infected cell. The new virus particle gets released outside the membrane and it is now free to affect any of the healthy cells that are present nearby, and that's how the infection spread. Once the virus enters inside your body through your eyes, your nose, your mouth, etc. So please be safe and please wear masks and follow every guidelines that government is providing. And thank you for watching this whole video. If you have any doubts, any queries, you can comment in the comment box. And thank you.